All right, let's talk potatoes. Potatoes, for me, are one of the best things God ever invented, and most of you are doing it wrong. So I'm going to teach you four ways to make delicious potatoes. First, mashed. We're going to mash some Yukon Golds. Second, baked potato. Got to bake a russet potato. Third, boiled. We're going to boil some baby reds. And lastly, fried. We're going to do some fried smashed fingerlings. I see potatoes in three different ways. You got waxy, like these little baby red ones. You've got mealy, like fluffy ones, like these russets. That's why I like to bake these, nice and fluffy. And then kind of in between, to me, fingerlings and Yukon Gold, these gold potatoes with the thin skins are kind of like in between, a little bit waxy, a little bit mealy. And I love making mashed potatoes and even like the fried fingerlings out of these. All right, first thing we're doing is a baked potato. I like russet potatoes. Stab it a few times so that it doesn't explode. It'll do that. I just stabbed it three times with a fork. Oil it. This is like my little 75% canola, 25% olive oil blend I made. Coat it nicely in oil. Coarse ground kosher salt all over it. No, it doesn't matter if the holes are facing up or facing down. I've got my convection oven at 350 and I'll throw this in there. I don't know how long, I'll let you know when it comes out. All right, now mashed potatoes. I'm using Yukon Golds and I always use Yukon Golds. Main reason is because the skin is so thin, you don't have to peel it. Stop peeling it. And people peel russets and I just prefer these better anyway. They're like really creamy and rich when it's finished. So put it in here, cover with cold water and salt. Boil it till it's really soft.
Now, the reason I said cold water instead of hot water, because obviously you're bringing it up to a boil anyway, so it's gonna be hot to cook the potatoes. But when you start cold, it holds the potatoes together. If the potatoes are boiling too hard, or you start in already boiling water and then throw them in, the potatoes kind of break apart, which is gonna give you more of a watery mashed potato than like a rich, creamy mashed potato.
Okay, so for our boiled baby reds, they're gonna start the same way as the mashed potatoes, cold water, salt, boil them until they're soft. The fried fingerlings, same thing. We're gonna start them the same way, cold water, salt, boil them till they're soft. All right, we got our boiled baby reds. We've boiled our fingerlings and our golds for the mashed potatoes. They're all really soft to the touch all the way through, so I'll show you how to finish them up. Baked potatoes done, it was exactly 45 minutes. Again, your oven, your potatoes, it could be more, it could be less. It should just be nice and squishy. All the way through, hot potato. So I can tell by squishing it that it's perfectly cooked. Give it a little split, give it a little squish. That's like a TV baked potato right there, it's beautiful. Throw your stuff on it, butter, a dollop of daisy. What you got? Some bacon over there, some green parts, some green onions. That's a proper baked potato. Let's talk sour cream real quick, people. I'm not calling this a life hack. Sour cream should be light and fluffy and delicious. So give it a little whip before you use it. Creamy. All right, to finish the mashed potatoes. I got this pot still pretty hot. I strained all the potatoes. They're sitting in the strainer. You gotta mash them while they're hot, so we gotta move kind of quick. This is about a half stick of butter. My butter just doesn't look like your butter probably does. But I'm gonna let that melt. And I'm not making garlic mashed potatoes, but I'm gonna put a little bit of fresh garlic in there because when you got the tube, it's really hard not to. So I did like a half tablespoon. A little bit of butter and pepper on my garlic. We're melting and cooking that garlic just a little bit, not to where it colors, but just to where it's maybe light brown, but kind of so that some of the aromatics come out. I'm going to add about a half a cup or 1 cup of cream. This is for 8 big old potatoes. Bring it to a boil with the potatoes in there, and then I'm going to smash it all up with a whisk. I love using a whisk for my potatoes. All right, so I got the butter and garlic, salt, pepper, and cream boiling in here. Put the potatoes back in there, just heat, making sure the potatoes are wicked hot before I start smashing them. All right, at this point, you can season them to taste. Add a little bit more cream if you want them a little bit creamier. I like black potato in my mashed potatoes. I mean,
black pepper.
I like black pepper in my mashed potatoes. That's it. This is a great time also to add in maybe some blue cheese or some wasabi and ginger if you're doing like a seared ahi as a side, or maybe I talked on another episode about doing some charred scallions. You puree those in a food processor and whip them in. Tons of flavor. Put some buffalo sauce in here with some grilled chicken. Put things in your mashed potatoes. All right, about to show you one of my seriously favorite things to do with potatoes. So the fried fingerling potatoes. We boiled up some little fingerlings. We only had little ones. Sometimes they're bigger. Use them all the same. Boil them in salt water till they're soft, and then chill them in the fridge till they're completely chilled. Really helps the starches kind of set up. And then take them and just smash them. I mean, you can do a whole bunch at once, or you can just kind of do one at a time with a little plate or something till they're like that, nice and smashed. I'm gonna do that to all of these real quick. I added my 75-25 canola olive oil blend to this pan. It's about a half cup. I should have used a smaller pan. I could use a little bit less oil, but I want it to come up maybe a quarter of the way up the potatoes on each side. So I put these in here like this. And you just fry them up until the white part on the inside gets nice and brown.
Yeah, everybody two-step in the motherfucker. Woo!
Two-step in the motherfucker. All right, I propped up a Gimpy taste tester to finish the fried potatoes and the boiled potatoes. So, first the fried fingerlings. So, there's them after I pulled them out. You could season these with anything. Obviously, the garlic salt be great on it. Throw in some chili powder and cumin, make a little Mexican. Throw some garam masala or curry powder. You could do so many things. I'm gonna show you the best thing. So I'm gonna put them in here. If you got some of this Hidden Valley Ranch dressing mix, I'm not gonna lie, I love it because of the MSG, and I love me some MSG. We don't use MSG in the restaurants, but I wasn't mad at the MSG I ate when we were out in Japan. So let's see. That's the fried fingerlings. We'll see what you think.
Can I have a piece?
Yeah, get in here. You gotta tell them what you think of it though.
Bomb.
So yeah?
Good.
Actually?
Delicious.
Want some?
Sure. What is actually?
It's a fried fingerling potato.
Oh, what the heck?
Yeah?
Yeah, it's like a french fry.
Delicious.
All right.
Salty.
Okay, now get out of here. We're on camera.
Goodbye. Oh, that's so good.
All right, now the boiled baby reds. Just strain them off. Just adding a little bit of butter. I'm gonna go a little bit of garlic salt. Remember, you, they already got some salt from the water when we cooked them, so be careful. A little bit of pepper. Just stir that until it melts. That's it. Just a little bit of butter, garlic, salt, and pepper. Delicious boiled baby reds. Here's a little life hack for you. Just found one of these little bread clips on the counter. You snap this in half. You got two of them like this, right? You fold it over your finger. They zoom across the room. Oh, hey, Haley. All right, well, thanks for learning how to make some potatoes with me. If you didn't watch the Coq au Vin recipe that we ate these mashed potatoes with, definitely go check that out and have a good time. See you later.